Hi, I'm Chad Wunderlich with Viking Pump, and if you've missed our videos in the past about pump operation, you're in luck. Today we're going to be talking about circumferential piston pumps, how they operate, and where to find them. You're watching the Pump Report. Despite the name, circumferential piston pumps, or CPPs, have more in common with external gear pumps than with traditional piston pumps. Like a gear pump, CPPs move fluid using two rotating elements called rotors. These non-contacting rotors are rotated independently inside a close-fitting housing. And here's how it works. As the rotors rotate, a cavity is formed at the inlet side of the pump. This creates a vacuum that pulls liquid into the spaces between the tips of the rotors. The liquid is then trapped between the rotor and the close-fitting clearances of the casing wall. The rotation of the rotors carries the liquid around to the outlet side of the pump. The tight clearance between the rotor and the hub of the opposite rotor ensures that the liquid does not pass between them. This reduction in the size of the pumping cavity forces the liquid through the outlet of the pump and into the downstream piping. Because of their large pumping cavities and their ease of cleanability, circumferential piston pumps are commonly found in applications like meat processing, dairy, and personal care. The non-contacting rotors are possible because each rotor is driven independently on its own shaft. A pair of external timing gears ensure that the rotors do not contact. To learn more about circumferential piston pumps, or to view other pump reports, please visit our website at vikingpump.com.